Furza. So you can see, here we go, side by side. These are the finals.
So Michaela Arlen-Kotlinski looking up the inside in turn one. She's got the orange colored roll cage, trying to make a pass. I think it's on Hailie Deegan. She might have pulled that off, you know. Down now, they're heading straight onto the loose section. Three cars wide in the background. Underneath that gap jump, everybody looking for a place to get through. This is the first time we've seen these cars quite so close together in such a big pack. And it is Willis leading from Arlen-Kotlinski, has made it up into P2. And in fact, Hailie Deegan's dropped down to fifth, Jared.
Wow, yeah, that's a considerable jump there. And I mean, just overall, what do you got?
There's a lot of cars out there, a lot of yellow roll cages. You know, do us a favor, people. We need flags or something, you know?
Yeah, I mean, between the numbers being small and you know what I'm thinking about is there's a lot of exposed tires. So Fraz getting, you know, with the next car, supercars, you don't have exposed tire, but having the side-by-sides, you could go up and over.
I mean, the only time I've driven something anything close to this is on the farm, you know, open road, just having fun. But to be racing side-by-side with these guys, they have to, I think, be very careful of going wheel-to-wheel because, you know, they'll ride up on each other.
Right.
They can jump up in the air. But, I mean, these things are flying, you know. In wet conditions in Minnesota, they were putting on faster times than supercars.
Yeah, they've got good traction, haven't they? And being a bit softer and higher, they generate a bit of grip. Arlen-Kotlinski going defensive there from Maddison in behind Robbie. Maddison trying to pass her. This is a great drive. I spoke to Michaela yesterday, Jared, and she said she was struggling to get a feeling for the car on the tarmac because it's so soft and it wallows about. And here she is hustling Willis big time and holding off Maddison.
Yeah, Maddo, look at him jumping up to third. And look at, you can see our top five drivers actually taking that Joker lap. Now, keep in mind, the Joker lap is shorter, the shorter lap for the next cars and the side-by-sides.
Yeah, they've all been in already, which is pretty standard stuff when the Joker's shorter, the leaders go early to protect their position. We think as well, Jared, that it's actually only a couple of seconds, I believe, the difference between the two laps. So all of them have been in, and really only McFarland is in any danger of being eaten up by Lawrence. Like, he's the only one who's within 2 seconds of the one at the back. The front three have got another 3 seconds on P5.
Yeah, there's a big gap from the top four to the rest of the field. And you can see Cleetus McFarland there sitting in fifth. And Maddo gets jumped by Williams. So Blake Williams jumps up to third. And you talk about Michaela.
I'm super impressed here. These are expert side-by-side races that Michaela has been doing Extreme E this year. She's got quicker at each event. Jared, it's been impressive. But to come here and throw down like this, not losing any time at all. She's actually gapped. I mean, okay, Maddo and Williams have been into each other a little bit, which has slowed them up. Such great racing from these cars. Fraz, you know, this is fun.
Yeah, man, you know, I think it's pretty cheap racing for the type of speed that they get. I've never been able to sit in one of these high-performing ones, but, I mean, you look at the suspension on them and what they can go through with it. They can put it through a lot of stress and still bring it home, and I think it's a great entry-level class, for sure.
They'd be fun on the farm, wouldn't they? You've got room for these on the Jamaican Rallycross track that we're all rooting for you to build so we can come to Jamaica?
Of course. Everybody's waiting for COVID to ease off in Jamaica a little bit so we can get Yardman racing going full on. But, you know, right now all my focus is on Nitro and trying to get this done. But, you know, all the Jamaica guys came out to show their support, and I'm so grateful for all the love that they're showing. And, you know, they're bringing some great energy.
All right, so Corey Willis still out front, just getting all the clean air from jump, and continues on. A little hiccup there as Michaela waiting for Corey to make a mistake and seize the moment.
Arlen-Kotlinski's closer than she was before. She's 5/10 back. There are certain points on this track, Jared, where she's just being a little bit tidier and maybe getting more traction on the exit. Got to watch out, obviously, behind for Williams, who's now closing that gap up as well. And Willis takes another 10th out. Michaela through. But look how close she's on the exit of turn one. Michaela.
Whoa! Got a almost, roll. Looks like Maddo almost ended up on his roof on that 90. It was off camera.
Out front, Willis is right out in the roost on the side of the circuit, where Arlen-Kotlinski's sticking to the cleaner bits of track. Just desperately trying to make something happen. 6 laps, remember, for the finals here. It's a long old lap, Fraser. Have you noticed the difference in the car? You've got it. You can't make mistakes out there, can you? If you want to nail the lap times, there's a lot of apexes to hit.
Yeah, it's the longest lap I've ever had to do in a rallycross race, and, you know, a lot of tarmac. So I've even had to be doing a little more left foot braking than I usually do. And in the practice, the brakes actually overheat and went straight to the floor.
So
I had to bring it back in. But, you know, very, very different, and I'm enjoying it quite a lot as well.
All right, so Corey Willis still out front, just making it look easy. Set it and forget it. Hailie Deegan does jump up to fourth position. Again, just off camera on that first corner. Oh, wow, look at that. So going around into the dirt section. Matto almost ended up on his roof. He was really high-sided, almost ended up rolling it, but fought it back.
Bilko's nearly back in this, Jarrett. So Bilko's onto the back of Arlen Kotlinski. Took the alternate line that Travis and Liam took this morning on the dirt. It maybe didn't work, but he's coming up close. And Arlen Kotlinski again is closing down on the brakes to Willis. So Bilko in P3, Arlen Kotlinski and Willis out front. Great race. Now Arlen Kotlinski dives in from a long way back, trying to close that gap up. This is a fantastic battle out front.
Yeah, really well done there. I think Michaela might strike. You can see Corey, he's really working his wheel, but Michaela.
Less inputs, you know, less inputs, yep. And maybe a bit more output. What's your take on it, Fraz? You're the pro.
You know, Bilko's going to be crossing his fingers, hoping that one of them in front of him makes a mistake. You know, Michaela seems to be catching it and loses it back. Maybe there's a little bit of overdriving, but Bilko looks like he's found some serious pace, and I wouldn't be surprised if he makes up a position right now.
And such a star-studded cast. We talked about Michaela, which name sounds familiar because obviously a family thing here, racing at Next as well. But Cleetus McFarland, unfortunately, not showing up here, or, you know, not performing. He only had one lap.
There it is. Bilko's going first.
Oh, here we go.
So watch for Bilko taking the alternate line, rotates the car on the gravel. Michaela has a little bit of understeer mid-corner, and now Bilko tries to find a little bit of extra exit speed. Michaela's very good on the brakes, it seems, at the end of the straight. The first sector is where she seems really strong, but Bilko now could strike. White flags out for the last lap. Watch for Bilko. Is Michaela aware that he's there? She goes defensive on the brakes at the end of the straight as we see Willis leading, and she just holds on.
So Willis is out front, and these two are fighting for the second spot. Look at Bilko just nipping on the heels of Michaela.
This has probably helped Willis now, because Michaela's now got to watch her mirror. So Willis is just free. You remember, it was 5 tenths. It's now 1.2. Bilko's looking left and right, isn't he? And those yellow colours will be flashing up large in Michaela's vision in the mirrors.
Willis and his partners are going to be very happy. Oh, here we go. Oh, Bilko going on the inside.
Oh no! Bilko rolls. He tried the move. It didn't quite come off. Tucks the wheels together. He lies sideways on the track. It's the last lap, so I'm confident they won't red flag this. And Willis.
Nothing tried, nothing gained. Well done, Bilko.
Yeah.
Great
effort. Bilko, risk it for the biscuit. It didn't end up paying off.
No biscuit. There was no biscuit.
Just dirt.
The cookie crumbled, whatever analogy you want to say, but right now it's all Corey Willis. Corey coming on in. Couple more turns for the victory. Our side by side.
Bilko's on the roof.
There he goes. Bilko's out. He's moving. And here we go with a checkered flag for Corey Willis. Get the win at side by sides with Mikhail Alekolinski. And it looks like Lawrence.
Yeah, right. So it's Scotty Lawrence who ran ran Travis's car and Katie Munnings. In fact, he runs Michaela Arlen Kotlinski's car, so that's a great result for them. Two cars on the podium. Not sure who runs Willis. There's Bilko out the car. Bilko, very entertaining guy on Instagram. If you follow Bilko, he's got a lot of videos from a long time ago. I'm getting nods from Trevor Piranha. Bilko posts stuff, and you're like, oh mate, no way, really? You got a video from then? So I imagine he's that guy that makes his mates nervous. You know, do not post that video from then.
Too late. Yeah.
So, Fraz, I mean, as you said already, not the greatest day for you, but we're going to see you race tomorrow. I know you're going to give it your all, but how's your first season of NRX been, mate? What's your thoughts on this brilliant series and you know, how much you want to carry on doing it?
Oh, I definitely want to put together the budget to try and continue for next year. It's the most fun I've had in a season so far. You know, these tracks are crazy. I've never flown cars like this in my life, and, you know, dreamt about it, and now I'm doing it. Racing against the best drivers in the world, the fastest guys, and you know, to be right up in the mix with them every event is really fulfilling. But you know I'll have what it takes to get there on top step, but everyone knows that motorsports is very, very unforgiving, and it just takes one little thing to go wrong, and we've seen to have that one little thing every single race.
Well, again, you started out the season, kind of had a little bit of bad luck here and there, but overall you've had a great attitude, and I think that's what's more important. You know, sometimes you win before you show up. I think you've definitely, you know, garnered a lot of fans across the globe.
Thank you, man. You know, putting a lot of effort off track to prepare for these races. It's an opportunity that I'm not going to let go to waste. A lot of people would be want to be where I am now. And you know, I'm trying to make my country proud, my sponsors proud, and my family as well. So
I think about half of Jamaica's down in the grandstand, isn't it? I mean, there is a huge contingent who have come across. Yeah, it's great for you.
Yeah, it's really celebrating. Congrats.
Great, yeah. Great. Congratulations to Corey Willis. Corey Willis, throw it down to Will.
With a very excited Corey down here now. Congratulations. Thank your words you to so me much. Just then. This was awesome. The fans were loving it. Wow, what an incredibly stacked field you got to do that against.
Oh, I mean, how about everybody racing these UTVs? I mean, geez, this was awesome. I mean, Travis, Nitro Cervic, Nitro Rally, amazing. This is absolutely awesome, and I'm just happy to be a part of it.
Now, you had some incredible racing going on right behind you. I don't know how much of that you were aware of. Did you see it?
So my spotter, my brother, Jacob, was in the stands, and he said, man, Michaela's on you, she's on you. So she kept the pressure. It made it super fun. What a race.
You performed under the pressure. Congratulations, Corey. Enjoy.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And thank everybody. This place is awesome.
Guys, he is having a lot of fun.
Yeah, very entertaining. Love the side-by-side introduction. We saw them at ERX and then coming back here to this course, rightfully
Thanks,
so.
Thanks, dude.
And
what
again,
a good time. What
there
a
we
good
go.
Time,
there's a great testimonial. Look at that haircut. You need
good race.
It's mullet season.
It is mullet season, man. That's the Texas mud flap, the Florida Gator. Awesome racing again. Just to see the side by sides out here. We saw a variety of different racing this season, but the side by sides are a great introduction.
Oh, Jared, you and me should have a race in side by sides. It'd be fun.
Yeah, I'm down. I'm keen.
Yeah. I'll make the contract. You guys sign it.
Let's take a look at the highlights. It was all Corey Willis, man, and only time he really got challenged was by Michaela, but then Michaela had to worry about Bilko in the rear view mirror, and then she didn't have to because he was on his side.
I think if Bilko hadn't shown up in that top three battle, if he hadn't got past, did he have to get past Maddo? I think he did, didn't
yeah.
he? And if he hadn't have done that, I think Michaela, we saw her lining up Willis a couple of times on the brakes the previous time onto the dirt, Jared. I think she had in mind a couple of places she might try and stick a move on him, but once that, you know, once Bilko turns up in your mirrors, and we just saw the gap go from 0.5 to 2.3, and yeah, game over. But I'm impressed by side by side again. Yeah, you know, we showed them at ERX and they were brilliant, and they've been great again here. But some stunning guest drives here as well. Bilko, yeah. Michaela, Arlen Kolinsky doing a great job.
Yeah, some very notable names, and Corey comes out on top and shows you that that he's here not to play but to win. And but again, Hailie, Deegan, Maddo, Bilko, Michaela, Cleetus McFarland, YouTube sensation. I mean, it's cool to see the variety. Unfortunately, Cleetus won't be joining us tomorrow.
Here is Bilko going on his roof, unfortunately.
And then, bonk.
Oh, he's so unlucky, isn't he? It's almost like the wheel hooks in behind the curb. You can't quite see. I'm just hoping it didn't scuff the cage too badly down the road there. And that we can see him back again tomorrow. Because he's in for both days, isn't he?
Right, so. Yep. And then this was my point earlier. I was talking about Fraz when he opened up and had you on. Is the exposed tires, you know, just getting up and over. So he kind of just locked it right in there like a Lego and just.
Those Yokohamas are grippy, man.
Yeah.
They'll throw you over.
So you see him just lock in, bump, and nope. Those things don't. I mean, you can drift them, but once that thing grips, it's over.
And you can see Bilko's trying to be a little nice. He didn't want to, you know, sideswipe and take her out. So. Tried to ease up a little bit, but that way transferred us, got the better of him, and over she went.
And there he is, getting out of the car.
Yeah.
Hey,
good lad. Yeah, go on. Yeah, that's so Bilko, isn't it?
Yep.
Awesome.
I mean,